गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर हियर विद क्लास 6 कंप्यूटर साइंस. ओके, इन द अर्लियर रिवीजन चैप्टर सेशंस वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट लेसन 1 एंड लेसन 2. इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट लेसन 3, दैट इज फाइल मैनेजमेंट, द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ डेटा इन द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम इन द फॉर्म्स ऑफ डिफरेंट फाइल्स एंड फोल्डर्स. एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट some of the important features or the new features of Windows operating systems like SIC feature, PIC. Then we will discuss here about jump list and what are the different file formats available in operating systems, as well as we will discuss about the how to search the files and folders within the computer system like using the wildcard characters. Clear? So first of all, when we perform any task on the system, we go for saving the particular data or the information on the computer system for the future use. Okay, and after creating or after performing any task, when you save the data on the system or any information on the system, then for that particular data or the information, a new file is being created on the system, okay, after saving the file to the memory device. Clear? In same way, to arrange the data or the similar data together and to organize your data in a proper way, we used to create a folders. Okay, so first of all, in file management or organization of data, the most important thing is the file. What is file? The file, it is basic unit of storage. It is a basic unit of storage, and whenever we create or we save any data to the memory device, whenever we save any data to the memory device, a particular file of that data or the information is created on the system. Okay, so when you use a program and save your work, a file is created automatically by the system itself, and the files created in a different applications may have different icons also. As you already know, you have studied in your earlier classes in class 3rd or 4th that what are the icons are there. Okay, so as you know, the icons are the pictorial representations of any files, folders or the programs. So each and every data or the file which is created by the system has its own icon. Okay, looking icons is different. So after creating the file, suppose there are different number of files are being created on your system and you want to organize your data properly, or you want to manage your file system properly in the system, like you want to keep all the music related file at one location, you want to keep your all the documents, important documents or the documents related content in a safe place, or if you want to organize all your different Word programs together, file created by the Word programs together, PowerPoint programs together, and in same way, if you want to keep your spreadsheet programs or the data separate, so you can create a different number of folders. The folders are basically created by the users, and through creating the folders, you can keep your files in an arranged manner. So the folder is a location in the computer memory used to store both files and folders. It is a location on computer memory used to store files and folders. Files and folders. The folders are capable of storing or containing the files as well as it can also contain the folders also. And there is another term that is called subfolder. The subfolders are basically the folders which are stored inside another folder. The subfolders are the folders stored inside another folder. The folder stored inside another folder is called subfolder. Clear? So this is the files and folder. Now we will talk about the memory storage device. You can even store your files and the folders in different memory devices like your hard disk. Then you can store it on your pen drives, or you can directly keep it on some external hard disk connected to your system, or on your CDs or DVDs even also. But the basic storage device which is connected to your system is your hard disk drive. The hard disk of the computers are basically, it is used to store the data on the computer, and it has the capacity or the capability to store a very huge amount of data within it. And you can divide or you can create a different partitions of your hard disk according to your need or according to your choice virtually. You can divide your hard disk into different partitions. Like you can create a different number of drives, okay, of your hard disk, and maximum the 4 different partitions are allowed of different sizes. Depending on your requirement, you can divide the hard disk into different category, different drives, and of different sizes you can notify it by yourself, and you can select the sizes and you can rename the hard drives according to your choice. And it is this partition is only created virtually. In physical manner, if you see in physically, the hard disk is not divided into different categories. The hard disk is there itself and it is a single hard disk. And if you want to divide it, you can create a different virtual drives within your hard disk. Okay. Then there are some other removable storage media within your systems. Like you can directly divide your file, you can store your files, or you can store your files into different folders within your different storage devices like CDs, DVDs, and even on the pen drives. Okay. Now some of the another most important thing regarding the files and folders is that the file formats. The file format, as you see, the file formats are most important thing regarding the programs we are using. The file, according to the file format itself, the computer system decides that which type of program is required to open that particular file or folder which is been accessed by the user. Okay, so it has been identified through the file format. By looking to the file format, system identify that which application program is required by the system to open that particular file or the folder which the user wants to open. So when we store or we save, give the command to store the data or the information on the system, when we give the command to the computer to store the files or the folders of data or the information of different application programs on the system, at that time when you give a save command, at that time the system asks you to select the location of the file. First of all, important thing is that you have to select the location of the file, and then you have to specify the name to that particular file. You have to specify the name of the file through which you want to save the data. Okay, but when you see the file names, any program file names, if you see, suppose you have saved any file name with ABC, you have given the name to the file is ABC, but you have saved it as a ABC, but if you try to open, when you open that particular file, or you want to, if you see the properties of that file, then you can see the complete name which is visible to you is, suppose it is written like abc.txt, it is written here abc.txt, that so this is the complete file name which is given by the system itself, and the first part of the file, any file name, the first part of any file name is given by the user. It is given by the user, whereas the second part of the file name is given by the system, and through which the system only identifies that which program is required to open that particular program or the file. Clear? So there are different file formats for the different application programs. Like suppose if you talk about .txt, if it is .txt, then system will automatically use Notepad or WordPad to open it. System will automatically use the Notepad or WordPad to open it. If you are given the file name as abc.html, you have given the file name as abc.html, then it will open it through using the web browser. It will open it through using the web browser. If you have given the file name as abc.pptx, then it will use a PowerPoint application program to open that particular file. Clear? So some more other examples are already given in your book. You can go through it and you can learn it for the exam point of view also. Then the another topic which we want to cover, that how to move or copy the files or folders within the system. How to move or copy the file or folders within the system. Okay. After creating any file or folder, if you want to move it from the original location to some other location, or you want to create a duplicate or copy of that particular data or the file, then you can do it by using the option of moving or copying the files or folders. So first of all, you can move or copy the files within the hard disk drive. You can move it from one drive to the another drive, or you can also move it in between. You can exchange the data in between the one external device to the another external device, or you can send it from hard disk to pen drive, or you can send it to hard disk to CDs or DVDs. So the most important difference between moving or copying any file is that if you are moving the file, you are moving the whole program or the file from the original location and you are sending it to the new location. Whereas if you are using the copy option, you are creating the duplicate copy of the original file, where the file appears on the both the location, original location as well as the on the new location also. Clear? So if you are trying to move the complete file from the original location to the new location, you can use the moving a file option, and for that you can use the options, that is cut and paste. You can cut the file or folder from the original location and you can paste it on the new location. Okay, the cut and paste option is also available on, you can use the cut and paste option from different features or tools. Like it is available on the organize option. Within the organize option, it contains the cut and copy option, or you can use directly the shortcut keys from your keyboard. That is, for cut it is control plus x, and for paste it is control plus V, or even you can use your mouse and you can right click on the particular folder. You can click on the right click your mouse on particular folder and you will get the option of cut. And once you click on the cut, you can move to the new location, and there from there you can again go to the new location and you can right click on there and you can select the paste option. The file automatically moves to the new location and disappears from the original location. Whereas if you are using the copy option, you are creating a duplicate copy of the file on both the locations at a time. Okay, you are creating a duplicate copy of both file on both the location at a time. Okay, the file appears on the original location as well as on the new location also. And for that, you have to use the commands like copy and paste. Again, the copy and paste options can be accessed through different features or tools. Like first of all, you can use it through the organize option. For that, select the file, go to the organize and select the copy option. Move to the new location. Again, click on organize and select the paste option. The another way to copy and paste is either you can use the shortcut keys from your keyboard. Select the file and press the shortcut key Ctrl plus C. And then move to the new location and press the shortcut key Ctrl plus V. The file will be pasted there. Or the third option is using your mouse. You can right click on the file and select the copy option. Go to the new location, right click, and you will get the paste option where you can paste it. Okay. So this is how you can organize your files and folders for future use within your systems. Now we will discuss about some of the special features of Microsoft Windows 2007 operating system. You have already discussed some of the features in earlier classes in class 3rd, 4th and 5th. Now here we will discuss some new features. Like the most important is jump list. Jump list option is generally used to jump to the any file for a particular application, any file of a particular application. Okay. For using this feature, what you have to do, when you click on the start button, the start menu appears, then you go to that particular application program option. And in front of that, you can see an arrow key is there. And when you bring your mouse cursor or point your mouse cursor to that particular arrow, then it will display you the currently used programs. And from there, or the currently used files through that particular application programs will be displayed. And from that list, you can select any file which you want to open and you can open it. Okay. The another way of using the jump list is using the taskbar. If suppose your program is already pinned to the taskbar, it is visible on the taskbar, then you can take your mouse cursor, go to the taskbar, point to that particular icon of the program, and as you point to the icon, it will display you the list of the recently used files of that particular application program. And from that list you can choose the file which you want to open it. The another feature is pinning. Any program to the taskbar, how to add the icon of the program to the taskbar. Okay. The pinned program can be accessed by just clicking on the icon on the taskbar. It is the easy way to access to any application program. Suppose if you are going to use any application program, take an example that you are using any PowerPoint program very frequently on your system. You have to perform lot of tasks with a PowerPoint program. So every time, either by using the method of going to the start button and then going to the start menu, and then from there you have to select the PowerPoint, you can just add the PowerPoint, Microsoft PowerPoint program, to your taskbar. And as you click on the program icon on the taskbar, the program window will be opened for you, okay, and it is available for you for performing the task or for working, okay. So the pinning feature can be used just like, first of all, what you have to do to pin any program to the taskbar is just click on the start button. Click on the start button, the start menu appears, and then go to the any application program. Go to the application program and right click your mouse, and you will get the option pin to taskbar. You will get the option pin to taskbar. As you click on the pin to taskbar, to select the option, the particular program icon will be visible to you on the taskbar. And now whenever you want to open that particular program, you can directly use your mouse cursor and you can click on the program icon on the taskbar, and the program will be opened for you. Another feature is pick. The pick feature is basically used to see or to view the desktop screen temporarily in between working within any application program. Suppose you are working on any application program, and in between that, if you want to view the desktop screen for some duration of time, then you can use the pick operation, pick feature of your Windows operating system, and you can temporarily view the desktop screen. For that, what you have to do, on the right hand side, where the clock is displayed, along with the clock, there is a pick button is there. While working to any application program, as you bring your mouse cursor to that pick button beside the clock, then it will temporarily display you the desktop screen The another feature which you want is here is snap. The snap feature generally used, or it enables you to open two different programs windows on your system. It enables you to fit two different program windows on your screen, and you can simultaneously work on both the programs. Clear? So suppose, like, take example that you have opened the word processor program, like Microsoft Word, as well as you are working on the Excel spreadsheet also. So in order to avoid the confusion, or if you want to do not want to close the program or to minimize the program, you can use the snap feature, and through using this feature you can fit the program windows of both the application programs, and then you can use it there, and both the programs windows will be available on your monitor screen, and then you can simultaneously work on both the programs at a time. Okay, then we have to discuss about searching the files and folders. Already you know how to search any files and folders on your system, you already very familiar with that. But here another feature we like to discuss is that using the wildcard characters. Okay, the basic task of searching any files or folders is that you click on the start button and type the file name or the program name which you want to open. Okay, type the file name or the program name which you are trying to search, and it will, after that, press the enter key. It will display you the list of the programs or the files containing that particular word. But suppose there is this another situation where you does not know the proper or the complete name of the file or the folder, you do not know the name of the complete name of the file or folders, then how to search the file or the programs on your computer. So you can search, you can use the wildcard characters, you can use the wildcard characters to search such type of files where you do not know the name of the files completely. So there are two different wildcard characters are there. One is question mark and another one is asterisk. Okay, the one is question mark and another is asterisk. Using the question mark, if you are going to use the question mark as a wildcard character, so what you have to do, suppose if you want to search any file name with, you just remember that the particular file name or the program name starts with ABC. It starts with ABC, but you do not know the complete name of the file, then you can, after typing ABC, you can place the question mark symbol, and you can press the enter key, and it will display you all the files and folders which starts with name ABC. Okay, but the most important difference between question mark and asterisk is that the question mark symbol is only used to replace one character at a time. Suppose here if you are putting a single question mark symbol, single question mark symbol at a time, then it will only replace one character. So if you put a two question mark symbols, it will replace two different characters. But whereas the asterisk symbol or the asterisk wildcard is used to represent any number of characters. It represents any number of characters. Like suppose it is ABC asterisk. Then it can replace the any number of characters, or it will display you all the files and folders which starts with name ABC and ends with any number of characters. So this is the basic difference between the wildcard characters, question marks, and the wildcard asterisk symbol. Clear? So this is all about this session. When we meet in the next session, we will discuss about how to create the tables and how to work within the table. Till that time, thank you and have a nice day.